Bible Stories in Series, Episode 18, Jacob's Journey. Dear friends, didn't we stop our last story till Isaac sent Jacob to Laban's house? Jacob obeyed his parents and went to Paddan Aram. Esau, hearing that Isaac sent Jacob on his way and commanded him not to take a wife from the women in the land, and knowing that his parents did not like his Canaanite wives, went to Ishmael, the brother of Isaac, and took his daughter Mahalath as his wife. Jacob, who was on his journey to Laban's house, reached a certain place, and he stayed there that night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in the place to sleep. And he had a dream. Behold, there was a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And the Lord stood above it and said, I will give this land to you and your offspring. Your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth. To you and your offspring, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed. He got the same blessing that his fathers got. Then Jacob awoke from his sleep. He understood that the Lord was in that place, and he was afraid. So early in the morning, Jacob took the stone that he had put under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. And he called the name of the place Bethel. Then Jacob made a vow, saying, If God will be with me and keep me in this way, that I will go and will give me bread to eat and clothing to wear, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then the Lord shall be my God, and this stone which I have set up as a pillar shall be God's house. And of all that you give me, I will give you a full tenth. Thus Jacob continued his journey and reached the city where Laban was living. And he saw a well and stood beside it. Out of that well, the flocks of sheep were watered. As he was standing there, Rachel, Laban's daughter, came with his flocks of sheep. When he knew that it was Laban's daughter, he watered the flock for her. When she knew who it was, she ran and told her father. As soon as he learned about Jacob, he ran to meet him and brought him into his house. Jacob stayed there for a month looking after his sheep. During those days, Laban told Jacob, Because you are my kinsman, should you therefore serve me for nothing? Tell me, what shall your wages be? Without hesitating, Jacob asked for Rachel, Laban's younger daughter, as his wife. I will serve you 7 years for her, he said. Laban agreed. Laban had another daughter as well, Rachel's elder sister Leah, but she was not as beautiful as Rachel. Because of that, Jacob asked for Rachel instead of Leah. Thus, with Laban's permission, Jacob worked for him for 7 years. But that time seemed like only few days to him because of his love for Rachel. When his time was completed, he went to Laban and asked for Rachel as his wife. So Laban made arrangements for the wedding, and he made a great feast for the people of that place. They all enjoyed and ate the feast. At night, Jacob went into his wife's room. In that room, there was a great surprise waiting for him. We will see what that surprise was in the next story. God bless you.